The Dischanter Beast. Now, this is a monster I'm going to consider adding to my personal game because I came across a miniature that sort of looked like the common image that you see associated with that. And that's of this creature here, which is kind of like a camel slash horse, which had this long tapir-like snout. And this miniature is one of the Safari Prehistoric Life Tube miniatures. It's very well in scale with D&D. Honestly, I don't know if I'm even going to bother repainting it because it looks pretty good. Now, the Disenchanter Beast can use its big old proboscis nose there to suck the magical energy out of an object, which is very, very interesting. Obviously, in 5e, there is a tendency for your characters to start accumulating magical items and then perhaps not be so keen to let them go. And in that case, the Disenchanter Beast might be a good idea to add to your game. Now, it was originally found in White Dwarf, and it was kind of more of a skinny, weird-looking camel thing. And then it was added to the Fiend Folio, and it turned out to be more of like a combat animal, sort of like a creature that was born and bred to combat evil mages. And in other systems like Pathfinder, like witch hunters used to use them as mounts, because the Disenchanter's natural ability to find and destroy magic was very beneficial to witch hunters. So there's some interesting stuff there. If you want to read up more, please go to the Daily Bestiary. And they talk more about the background of the Disenchanter monster. Now, I do want to note that this could be used in many different ways. The two ways that I kind of figured right off the bat is to have a pit trap, like a normal D&D pit trap, but instead of spikes or anything like that, there's a hungry Disenchanter Beast at the bottom of the pit trap. So the adventurer goes walking around, drops into the pit trap, and then the Disenchanter will get a free attack to try to drain one of their magical items. Now, you can be an evil DM and just have it destroy the magical item altogether and make it into a normal item, or maybe it just weakens that magical item for a number of days or something like that. The other idea that I had was to have the adventurers find a starving infant Disenchanter and for them to make the decision where they would let this innocent creature die a horrible death through starvation or give up one of their magical items for this creature to eat. And, you know, then maybe they'd find a use for it or let it go back into the wild. But it's just an interesting little idea to put out there that magical items are notoriously difficult to destroy in 5e. And so this might be an interesting magical beast to kind of add to your game. So in fact, all the different tube miniatures from the prehistoric life thing, the big human character guys, like those are not very useful at all. The fireplace is kind of cool, but the other prehistoric beings there, that's actually kind of interesting. There was one of the big giant sloths, and I actually have some footage here. These are a couple of my favorite from the pack. As you can see, the big old giant sloth there, I touched up kind of sloppily. But they're all pretty well in scale with D&D miniatures. The sloth especially, I think, is just, it looks perfect. Because I was actually looking through the old school D&D magazine, which is Dragon Magazine. So let me go back to that for a second. I got these issues of Dragon Magazine, and I picked them up from the local Savers, which is a thrift store in town. And they had all the super interesting, like, prehistoric beasts, including stuff like Giant Sloth and the Two-Horned Rhino and everything like that that were in the prehistoric tube pack. So I thought that was pretty cool. So if you happen to be able to get a good price on the tube at a craft store or something like that, that might be something you want to check out. Again, these miniatures are perfectly in scale with D&D for what the Giant Sloth is supposed to look like. And they're just, you know, some wacky good fun if you want to throw some prehistoric monstrosities at your party. Maybe there's a time travel thing, or maybe there's a Forgotten Valley where time runs differently. In any case, this Enchanter Beast really made me think of a lot of the older D&D monsters and how they could be homebrewed into 5e. Maybe not necessarily as monsters, but more, like I said before, as either a plot hook or a trap or something like that. So lots of interesting stuff to think about. I'm definitely getting a lot of ideas from these dragon magazines, and I am still hitting up the thrift stores to find more miniatures and stuff for the cheap miniature challenge. Though I might have to rename that video series because apparently social media does not like the word challenge in videos. Thank you for watching the video, and have a great day.